Hey guys, welcome back to No Catchy Name. It's me, Ella. Today is Wednesday, so it's What You Working On Wednesday. So I'm working on a whip that I have already started. You guys have seen it previously, but smaller. And it is a Halloween bag. Let me get the first page. Yeah. All right, here it is, a paid for pattern by Heidi Yates, which is Snappy Tots. I love her patterns, but here it is. It's called Halloween Sampler Bag, and I'm going to be using it as my bag for this Halloween, and I do plan on lining it with fabric at some point. But there it is, the front and back of it. Tons of different yarns. I'm using, it's all Red Heart Super Saver except the orange. I can't remember what the orange is. Some random orange I bought at a local yarn store that has since closed, but I don't remember what it was. Anyways, so I sat on it and sat down and worked on it this morning a lot before Jesse woke up. I had like an hour and a half before he woke up this morning, so I was just working away on it. So last time you seen it, it was just a strip of colors where the little characters will be, this little strip. And so this morning I finished the bottom, which is adding these few rows of color and then the black, and then you left the long tail to like sew it up so it's like a bag. And then I attached the green to the top and am working on the green. I gotta do the green for 13 inches and then finish it off and work on Frankenstein's monster's hair. Yeah, and then I'm not sure where it goes from there. I think it works on his facial features, and then it works on all the other little characters' features, and then I think you do the handle last. I'm not sure. I haven't read that. This is my new stitch marker I just got out of a carousel swap. It goes good. But there's my bag so far. It's gonna look a lot different once the little character's on there. I think it'll be cute. And I'm gonna line it. I'm probably gonna line it with like a green fabric because the majority of this bag is gonna be green. But yeah, so I do remember some of these colors. Let's see here. This is Red Heart Super Saver Spring Green, Amethyst, Bright Yellow, Black, and the orange. I can't remember what that is. It's not a Red Heart Super Saver. I remember when I bought it, I bought two balls of it at a local yarn store that was kind of close to us, and it closed because they had some acrylic yarns in there, and I'm an acrylic person. So I bought two balls of that, and I used up most of it. This, I believe, is like half a skein that I have left, and I don't have the label anymore. But I just don't remember what that was. It's very similar to Red Heart, so it works. But yeah, so there's my Halloween bag so far. That's what I'm working on today. Like I said, I was working on it this morning, and now that we're back from doing some errands, we had to go to Jesse's school and get his little thing you hang in your car when you pick him up in a car. While we were there, we had to ask about a journal, because on the school supply list, it said that we needed a primary journal K through 2 purchase at school. So I was like, what the heck is that? Because I never had a kid in school before. I didn't know what that was. So we asked the lady at the school, and she showed us. And you can also get them at like Walmart and probably Dollar General and some other places that sell school supplies. And it's kind of like a composition journal where half of the page is blank so that they can draw pictures or glue things up there. And the other half of the page is like those little lines for little kids to learn how to write the alphabet and stuff the right size. I don't know what that's called, but like lined paper with little dots in it. So after she showed us what it was, she said they didn't have them at school yet, but on Monday they would have them at school ready to be purchased, but that we could find them, you know, at other places that sell school supplies. So we went to Walmart, and almost all the school supplies is horribly depleted. I'm so glad that we bought his school supplies when they first put it out, like a month and a half ago. We went ahead and bought everything because I like doing everything early. And so we walked on the paper aisle, and there was like hardly no paper. There was like a few composition books and a couple folders, and it's just pretty much empty. But in one of those little yellow boxes that holds like 10 books was one of those. I grabbed it and I flipped it open to make sure it was the right thing, because it looked, the cover was a little bit different than hers. Hers was like a like the Walmart brand. This one was like a different brand, Kid something, I can't remember. But it was the same thing on the inside, so that's what was important. And it was the last one there, and I was like, oh my god, we're so lucky that we just happened to find that. And that was the last thing we needed for his school, so he's ready for school. But anyways, this pattern I was talking about is really awesome. I love all of Heidi's patterns. They're all adorable. I have made so many of her patterns over the years, it's ridiculous. I have pretty much almost all of her patterns, all of them. I love them. I can't wait to get this done. And it's going to go cute with Jesse's little bag I made him last year. I still haven't lined that. I need to line that one. He didn't use it last year. He didn't want to use it. But I'm going to try to get him to use it this year. But because I will have kind of matching bags. But if not, I'll just have two of them, I guess. I don't know. But I will try to show when I line it. I know I mentioned that last year, and then I never did that because I never lined it. But it's pretty simple. But I do have a sewing machine, so I'll be doing it with a sewing machine. If you don't have a sewing machine, you have to sew by hand, which is still pretty easy. Because it's going to be inside the bag. And as long as it's for personal use, it doesn't have to be perfect. Because, like, for instance, I'm not weaving in my ends. Let me see where. I tie them in a bunch of knots. You can see them right there. And then I just trim them. Because it's going to be inside the bag, but also in between the bag and the liner. So it's not going to be visible. I don't know they're there. You guys don't know they're there. But nobody else will. So I'm super excited about this. I'm going to sit and work on this tonight. Because I'm tired. I'm going to sit and just relax. I'm so fatigued from this pregnancy. I don't remember it being this way with Jesse, but I mean, it was 6 years ago, so who knows. But yeah, we did that little bit of running around. We went to Dollar Tree because I was trying to see if they stocked their Halloween stuff, the wreath making things, because I need some of that mesh. I don't need it, but I want some of that mesh to make a wreath for my front door. I watched a YouTube video on how to do it, and it looked pretty easy. Knock on wood. We don't have any wood right here. Wood frame right there. But it looks like they had stocked some, but all of it was gone but the lime green. And I want purple, orange, and black. I've only gotten one purple. I think I need 5 rows of each. So I don't know if I'm going to be able to do that. I'm going to have to actually just go to Hobby Lobby or Walmart or somewhere and buy the more expensive, bigger rows. I don't know. I'll figure it out eventually. But I really want a really pretty wreath for my front door for Halloween because I don't have one other than my crochet wreaths. And I don't like hanging them outside because I'm afraid that they'll get damaged by weather and sun and all that. And I'm blabbing now. But I'm known for my blabbing, so it's okay. But we decorated for Halloween today in the living room. Me and Devin and Jesse could not wait any longer. We are all 3 Halloween heads, and we did it. It's nice and pretty. If I can think about it, I'll take some pictures and insert them here, or I'll for sure do it in the next No Kitchen Name episode. And I'll probably do a walkthrough like I do most years to show you guys all the crochet things that I have sitting around, because there's quite a bit of crochet decorations in there. And some of them are Snappy Tots. I have her Halloween flags. I need to make them. I have the ghost one and I think the sampler one. I need to make them and hang them up somewhere. But yeah, I'm gonna hop off here and catch my breath because I'm breathing deep. But and I'm gonna figure out what to do for dinner. I think we're gonna do breakfast for dinner tonight because we don't have anything thawed out but bacon. So we can make bacon and eggs, and we have cheese and tortillas, so we can make breakfast burrito type things. Those are really good. But I'm gonna hop off here. We're gonna go swimming later. And I'll catch up with you guys in another video. Also, I'm gonna insert, today is National Chocolate Chip Cookie Day. So make you some cookies or go buy you some cookies if you like cookies, and enjoy them. I have some cookies in the cabinet that is like a bag. You just mix like milk or egg or something with it, I don't know, and you make them. I'm probably gonna do that. I have all the stuff to make them from scratch, and I can make some really good ones from scratch, but I don't have the energy to do it. So unless Devin wants to do it, I'm just gonna make the ones in the pouch, but they'll still be good. And we'll still eat the heck out of them, I'm sure. But anyways, I'm gonna hop off here and I'll see you guys in another video. Bye guys.